Okay, so welcome. I want to. I'm here to show you to our advances. Also, is in the already shown project Spaceman, where we do the manufacturing demonstrators from tooling for the tooling industry with low cost powders. Therefore, we at AWS were working together with Gestamp. Provided some information for us there too, and I think it's there are already sufficient information about the project Spaceman already given in the earlier presentations by Maurizio, or for example also Flavia in a presentations before. So a short introduction of myself. I'm a researcher at the Fraunhofer AWS in the field of additive manufacturing with focus of material characterization and a special focus of powder characterization. And in the last 2 to 3 years, I worked on this project from the powder to the final product together with my colleague Francesco Pozzo. So I think we already have given some introductions into the laser metal depositions. So just let me give a short introduction into the process. So LMD is basically a method for direct metal deposition in one-step build-up process where we have a continuous supply of feedstock material. And this allows us the manufacturing of relatively big parts with a dense coating and which are metallurgically bonded to the substrate, and also near net shape material deposition and varial degrees of freedom. And we also have the possibilities of temperature tailoring and temperature control for controlling of the process. I also want to give a short introduction into the parameters we have there. There's on one hand, there's the laser power, the spot size, the powder feed rate, the velocity, feeding, shearing gas flow, and what's especially important in this project is, of course, the powder material, as should be clear. So therefore, I want to give a short introduction into cost-efficient raw materials. So in AM processes, as already mentioned, are challenging for mass production. So there's a lot of cost factors like production, composition of the powder, process duration, but also material consumption. So the target must be for this project. So it's also for the following presentation from Zamora to increasing the throughput and performance and efficiency of powder usage by the usage of, for example, low cost powder, and to find the right powder for the right application, which might also be for steel powder, common steel powder for the application for tooling industry. So as our project partner, Sven Beckson from Hugenes, already showed in before lunch, there are common types of powders. So we investigate gas atomized powder, liquid atomized powder, a mix of water atomized and gas atomized powder, and also pure water and atomized powders. And as already shown in the previous presentation and also earlier in this webinar, this the LVF process is relatively promising, but also the LMD processes delivers quite some good results for processing. So we at AWS are searching for sustainable powder usage, for additive manufacturing, which includes powder characterization, the metal deposition, process parameter search, and we want to get aims knowledge about powder usability and want to try for optimal process usability for powder and DMD, so to optimize the process. So in our project, in the Spaceman project, basically this can be subdivided into three main steps. At one hand, we had the low-cost powders, we did processing trials, derived some information about processability, the general material build-up quality, and at last tried to derive a suitable application for the powder, for example, for the tooling industry. So as Maurizio already showed two presentations before, the target of our project was the upscaling for the research market steel grades, for example, tooling steel. In our case, tooling steel for demanding applications. And we wanted to upscale the water optimization. It's a cheaper and more suitable powder synthesis process also, and also drive other powder feedstock sources for additive manufacturing MD. And in this case, we wanted to develop a business case in automotive sector, and therefore we, together with Jestamp, this was a die cast for, what, not a die, but a die for automotive sheet stamping developed. So to give another introduction into the used powder, on one hand, obviously there was gas atomized powder compared, which has a quite low oxygen level. The atomization process is basically state of the art. We have relative, for small batch sizes, we have lower costs, and for large batch sizes, we have high costs for consumables, for example, nozzle or the shielding gas, and the overall processability is relatively quite good. For water atomization, we have a obviously much higher oxygen level. We have the problem that we can't atomize elements like manganese and aluminium with this, and of course, high startup costs and cleaning costs. But that's why it's a low cost pool. We have low cost for consumables, and we have high efficiency of the process. But in process, we have a lower apparent density and irregular flowing behavior to cope with for processing. So our trials in the beginning were done first. We had several batches here. I wanted to give an example about water atomized and a mix up of gas atomized and water atomized powders. And there we did iterative process developments. Flavio, maybe you can mute your microphone, which was used to build up the common tracks, then also area scannings, and also volumes which were cut and then investigated. And to give you a small insight in the research done there, so we had to cope with a lot of defects while built up, which on the one hand, there were build-up errors, like a fusion port, like fusion errors here. We had some cracks due to intercrystalline cracks in the build-up direction, and also deformation of oxide due to residual oxides in the powder. But at last, this defects could have been mitigated due for the parameter optimization and further trials, and also optimization of the powder by business. So now I want to give a short insight into the application case at one. So our target application was the hot stamping process. This is basically a process used in automotive industry. So there is basically a blank sheet blank which is heated, and then heated in a furnace up to a specific temperature, and then pressed, and at last we have a hardened part which could be used for stiffening elements in the chassis of a car, as you can see here, where you can find application. And the big advantages, main trends in this application, are that we have a lower consumption of the final cast. So due to the high strength, we have a lower weight, and so we have a lower consumption. And due to the press hardening, we have a higher safety due to deformation allowance and advanced designs for crash performance. But why do we want to use additive manufacturing for this? So just a common stamping tool looks like this. We have a forming surface where the heat blanks makes contact to, and here at near to the surface we have cooling channels where the sheet is cooled and hardened that way. And as you can see, the the cooling channel geometry is quite complex, and additive manufacturing might enable an increased cooling performance of the part, and also decrease numbers in the tool, which I will show in the next slide. And this same process can also, of course, be used to repair worn and broken tool segments and decrease the total lead time of the tool manufacturing. One small concern, anybody has his microphone on? Could you please turn it off? So, to give this problem with the common problem or one challenge with pressing tools is they're usually assembled from segments which were pressed together with O-rings. And so we derived for our demonstrator a segment of this with a retrainer. And the main target in the future might be that we have one hybrid manufactured component with a DED with cooling channel and the surface, forming surface already realized. And at last, the target geometry, this was one of the first designs. As you can see, it's relatively complex cooling channels here. And therefore, we derived a simplified plane for a hardening tool and tried to assess the feasibility of the using of the process and some techniques by abstract geometry even more to analyze three main approaches to realize this cooling channels. Because as you know, the LMD process has a lower degree of freedom for of geometry or complexity of design. That's why we were analyzing basically three approaches. On the one hand, we analyzed a pre-milled part with chamfers, where we realized the chamfers and then do the top coating. In a second approach, we are doing doing tubes, which we fill here and then apply a top coating. And at last, a sheet approach, where we just apply a sheet here and then do top coating at last. So there is some challenges with manufacturing even with this approaches with the sheet and tube. So therefore, we have to control the penetration depth to avoid. We had to control the penetration depth to avoid the molten material to reach the cooling channel. And and we have to avoid a thermal deformation in the tubes in the metal sheet places of the cooling channel. So we first fixed the tubes and the sheets in the in their inserts with dots, and we used hybrid DED processes with an EMIX camera, which controls the laser power by keeping a constant position load. So this works basically with a control of the intensity of the melt pool. So now I want to give a short overview about this pre-processing trials. As you can see, we were successful for this. In the first step, we did a single track on each side of the sheets, and then did a top coating, which was rotated by 90 degrees. Unfortunately, in the first layers, there were some visible defects, but in the subsequent layers, they were smoothened and were less visible. And there was almost no significant, there was no significant thermal distortion in the sheets. The same was with our demonstrator tubes. We had, of course, some strong defects along the interface of the tube substrate due to the really, really small gap between the tube and the substrate. And for the second demonstrator, we tried, but there were also some defects. And here we also had no significant invisible thermal distortion of the sheets. And now I come to the more complex demonstrators for the walls. So there we had a challenge: how do we close the cooling channels at the wall? So therefore we analyzed two general approaches. At one hand, at first we wanted to close the channel with a roof and then do the fill the top layer on it. Or another approach was the volume build up layer by layer, and so closing it. And at last, we stayed with the first approach for a better top surface quality. Another issue we had in this with this geometry is that we had limitations of the accessibility for our nozzle. Due to the dimensions of this milled parts here, with 45 degrees chamfer angle, we had the risk to hit the part with the nozzle, and therefore we stayed with an angle of 40 degrees, which also led to good deposition results. So at last, we assessed our approach for the final demonstrator and compared especially the ease of programming, the productivity of this whole issues and geometric accuracy, and also the material quality and channel surface quality. Even though the tubes got some quite good results, the material quality was quite low. So for the final demonstrator, Gestamp relied on the application of a cooling channel with cover sheets and also with the walled approach. So they derived a tooling segment for hot pressing, which I will show now. So basically they derived from a few boundaries for the pressing, so it has to be simple enough for the DoD manufacturing of cooling channels, as shown in our previous building trials. And we had to take care that we have a 2 millimeter thickness of heat load while keeping forming forces reasonable. So this led to some simulations here, which also led to some considerations of no moving parts and the blank control in the tool. And it should, of course, mimic the same features as a common tool. So the part was designed, and as you can see, Gestamp took this chance to compare a half side conventionally manufactured and an additive cooling channel. So at one hand, we have for the additive part, we have one cooling channel closed by welding with a three axis LMD, which was closed by a sheet and closed as shown before, and some more complex features up here with chamfers which were closed, and via the LMD process we also applied an offset for later milling on the LMD part. So we have here the final build up. As you can see, it looks quite good. We had almost no issues with the process itself. We had this minor challenge with closing the chamfer part here, but the overall LMD deposition process took only 3.5 hours, and we had achieved quite good geometric accuracy. After the manufacturing of the part, the part was heat treated at IWS and then sent to Gestamp for the final building of the part. So, and as I'm informed, or as just I'm provided information, milling of the substrate and the deposited material was quite good, and we had no problem using the same tools and speeds and feeds as used for common material. And unfortunately, as you can see here, we had some pores to poor deposition there, but this shouldn't affect the functionality of the part, and this shouldn't for our validation of the part. So for validation at Gestamp, there was a hardness measurement conducted on the non-LMD side and the LMD side. And as you can see, the hardness of the DED side is a little bit softer than on the conventional manufactured side, but it's within the usable range for hot stamping. And yeah, so this is quite good, is a quite good result. Furthermore, the validation will be conducted from the tool will be conducted on the one side for direct validation press, so that there is no catastrophic failures, for example, cracks or plastic deformation during forming, and also the recorded temperature in the steel and the machine side are quite similar, and also in comparison with the temperature of the with thermal simulation, the results are quite good. And afterwards, an indirect verification of the spacement hot stamp tool will be done, where we had a microstructure of on the one side, the DED side, and the conventional side is checked, and also a hardness measurement along the sections will be done. So I like to close my presentation with a picture of the assembly of the demonstrator in hydraulic press for pressing for testing of the part in the next week. Maybe my colleague at Gestamp can give further information about this. And so I want to close my presentation now, and maybe give an hour, give in later time of this year, give another insight into the final results of the testing. And if there are any questions, feel free to contact me or Petter, and